North wind blows across the street and bites her face with hard, relentless teeth. Yes, and dampness creeps across her spine and shakes her bones all the way down to her feet. Well, in the park, with a strange and phantom mistress who keeps her treasure sealed in plastic bags, reciting to herself her ribald secrets, and wraps her frame in old discarded rags. Yes, and Magpie seeks out precious things, her bangles, trinkets, flecks that catch the light. Yes, and Magpie guards her shiny dreams and keeps them close and safely out of sight. Well, Magpie walks through the hordes of vain and shallow tritons, useless minds. Yes, and Magpie walks to and fro about the squandered wealth of affluent swine. Well, in the sky there's a strange engraven image of a man who would be savior to her kind. A great balloon that in the wind bobs merrily, with golden ring and arm stretched open wide. Ah, but Magpie cares not for charity or the creepy cloistered feel of fond embrace. No, sir, Magpie finds her peace of mind in the dark and dank and cold and secret place. Strange and wondrous temple, a crystal castle cut from chrome and steel. Its halls contain the bounty of the ages, so priceless that they almost seem surreal. The Magpie has seen the truth that lurks in shadows cast by tinted glass. Yes, and Magpie, all her righteousness, knows just who is wallowing in trash.